My son just passed out in school for wearing a mask. That's where I'm at. In PE, he passed the out because he couldn't breathe. A child who passes out during PE because he can't breathe because he's in a mask gets this mama bear pissed. This, America, is not okay. I will no longer put my children's life in your hands. America, wake the up. Something's gotta change.
We are devoting our show today to mothers, many of whom are being pushed to the limit under the relentless pressure of the COVID-19 pandemic. Tanya, you were really upset that, as any mother would be, that your child passed out at school, right?
Yes.
And you were very passionate.
I was. The school did not call me and told me that my son passed out. So my rage was through the roof because the school didn't let me know.
But you say he passed out because of the mask. Are you sure?
Yeah. My son's an athlete, has been playing soccer since he was 3 years old. And he's like, I don't feel good. And he started getting lightheaded and he took his mask and he's like, I got to take off my mask. And he blacked out.
Listen, I'm not a physician, so please don't rely on what I'm telling you. But I do, having been on the air as long as I have and worked with as many experts as I have access to the top medical experts in the world. And I know in talking to the World Health Organization, which you may or may not trust, and pulmonologists at Ohio State University, for example, that their findings are that prolonged use of medical masks can be uncomfortable. However, it does not lead to CO2 intoxication nor oxygen deficiency. So your O2 saturation levels don't go down. So there's just no evidence to suggest that that's the case.
So when a child says he can't breathe and he passes out, that's not enough evidence? You know what? Maybe we need 50 more kids to pass out and say, you know what? I couldn't breathe. The difference is, you're right, there's maybe experts saying this, but when a child comes to you and says, I can't breathe and passes out, that's when it's time for us to listen as mothers, as parents, and say, maybe something is going on that we need to look at here.
Well, but all I'm saying is I think it has been looked at, and that doesn't mean there aren't anecdotal exceptions. But Jill, Danielle, what do y'all think about this? Are y'all just giving in to fear-mongering and having your children wear masks?
If I may, it was mentioned a moment ago that it's going against our natural instincts to put masks on our children, our natural motherly instincts. My natural motherly instinct is to protect my child. And if that can be done by putting a piece of cloth over their nose and over their mouth to protect them and everyone around them, then that's the simplest form of protection. That's the simplest natural instinct I could have.
Well, I have to say, I agree with each and every one of you. As a mother, you have a right to do what's best for your child. I personally would do everything I can to protect my child in this very serious situation. This is the first time I know I've ever been a part of a pandemic, and I'm gonna do everything I can for my entire family and all of my children, my grandchildren, and both Philip and myself are wearing masks all the time.
Let me just put this button on it before we take a break here. I don't talk politics, and I just refuse to do it. I will say this. I think you have to look at the science. And if you look at the science, the science is very, very clear, and it doesn't matter which side of the aisle you sit on, that masks don't drop oxygen saturation. But Tanya, I think you've got to do what you think is right for your son. Well, hey, it's me, and thank you so much for watching. And while I have you, do you have a story or a question for me? If so, trust me, I want to hear from you. Click on the link in the description and tell me what in the world is going on. You just might end up right here on the show. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. Click that little red button below. You know you want to. What are you waiting for? Do it!